Hi, I'm Daniel Rechnitzer, and welcome to the Intuition Wisdom Channel. You know, every day we're helping liberate people from the rat race, helping them to become self-mastered and to live their life purpose, you know, to really make a difference to themselves and the planet. Now, if you're ready to change your life and step into your power and access that limitless intuition, then you've come to the right place. So today I want to share with you some golden highlights from my feature videos. And once you've checked this one out, remember to look at the description for more videos just like this one. All right, let's dive in.
Now, this new mind lie, the next one is another big one. And it is this: money is difficult to obtain. Money is difficult to obtain. It's hard to get. It's out of reach. A very commonly held belief. It's a societal belief throughout humanity. But again, a non-truth. But how many of us have believed that over our life? That that's what it is. It's just a fact. Just as a fact of giving, having childbirth is going to be painful, money's hard to get. It takes effort and it could take exhaustion. That's just reality. Well, it's not the truth. The same as birthing doesn't need to be painful. But what makes money seemingly hard to obtain, or the feeling or belief that it requires excessive effort? What does that? What creates that? Well, it's the belief that money is outside of me. Money is outside, separate, and distant. And this is exactly how most of us, if not all of us, relate to money. It's not who we are. It's not even a part of us. It is out there somewhere else in the world, in somebody else's hands. It's not me. It's not what I am. It's out there. And it's that belief that makes money hard to get. We're really creating our own reality. And this is another alarm bell. So when the mind has you see other things as separate and disconnected from you, it's a really good telltale sign that you're in the mind. If you start feeling money's out there, or this is disconnected, I'm not this, I'm not that, that's a non-truth. So let an alarm bell have you remember to come back into truth. Out of the mind and into truth. So what is the truth? The truth is this: all energies dwell within you. But it's the belief I am separate and disconnected from money itself that puts it at a distance, when in truth there is no distance. Now, you've seen this with the different energies we use at UI, whether we're bringing in self-belief or stillness or self-love. All these energies are accessible. When many of you thought they are external and at a distance from you, they are all very well within reach. Because despite what the mind says, they are all within you, the real you. They're not in the mind. So it's quite funny. The mind says, no, they're not in you. But what the mind is really saying, no, they're not in me. They might be in you, but they're not in me. And that would be true because these energies aren't in the mind for most of us. Just not there. So the mind is actually speaking truth. But the way we see it is it's talking about us, which is the non-truth. So what makes seeing money as internal rather than external is the thought that it's physical. And not only that, but someone else has it. That's what makes seeing money as internal quite challenging. Well, that's a physical object. That's definitely physical. The energy of self-love or stillness, yeah, they're energies. They're not physical. But money is clearly physical, at least as far as the mind is concerned. And that's what makes it challenging. It's just the mind's way of holding you back, because money is energy. Everything begins as energy. Its essence is energy. This label of physicality is from the mind. The mind decided This is a physical universe. This is a spiritual universe. It's all one energetic universe that takes on many different levels of frequencies and densities. Mind loves labels. Again, more alarm bells. Start labeling things or seeing labels on things, you can be very suspicious that you're in the mind. So what's the truth? It is this. Those with money and those without the constant need for money have realized something that many of you have not. And that is that the source of money is not from having the need for money, but rather in realizing I am money. Let me say that again. Those with money and those without that constant, perpetual need, that feeling, needing money, have realized something profound. And that is that the source of money does not come from having the need for money, but in the realization, I am money. Said differently, people who seem to possess a lot of money recognize a lot of money energy inside of them. Or, said differently, they see that they are made of money. And that's something my mother used to say to me as a kid growing up, was that person over there, they're made of money. And she said it in a negative sense, but it was really pointing to something she didn't have within her. She did not see that she had money energy. She was not made of money. Now, before the mind arcs up on that one, realize you are made of all energies. And all energies includes money energy. Allow that in. You are made of money energy. You are made of all energies of all frequencies. Take a moment to let that in. I am money. I am all energies. I am all energies. I am the money energy. I am the energy of money. Now, you might feel some reactions around that, and that's a good indication that where there's beliefs saying, no, I reject money, or money's bad, da, 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 da. They're all labels, they're all non-truths, they're all beliefs. So just keep going with that integration. And when you realize that, how can something be separate and hard to get? Which was what was that original belief, money is separate and hard to get. How can it be separate and hard to get if it's my intrinsic nature? These all energies are within and available. Makes sense. So you can see that money can't possibly be hard to get if it is your intrinsic nature. It's just the belief that it's separate and outside of me that makes it hard to get, seem hard to get. These are beliefs many of us are raised with, societal belief systems. Now, this brings us to a deeper truth about money being hard to get. And that is, money doesn't like being chased. To chase something comes from, I need it because I am without it. And this stems from seeing everything as external to you, which is not the truth. Everything is within. Now, money from a space of truth won't validate such a non-truth. So it will keep running away from you. That energy of I am separate, disconnected, unworthy of money repels money. Money says, that's not my truth. That's not your truth. I'm not going to be drawn into your energy if that's what you believe, because that would be validating that non-truth. And I'm here to help raise consciousness not stifle it. So money will keep running away from you if you believe it is outside of you, separate, or not of you. So seeing it as separate and hard to acquire pushes it away. Because money has a truth, and money's truth is this: I am available to all who see themselves as me. You might want to write that one down. Let me say it again. Money's truth is this: I am available to all who see themselves as me. And we become so conditioned to see ourselves through the lens of the mind that we are a human being and we are our physical bodies. But this is what the mind-wise journey is all about, what the book is all about, what our teachings are all about, is going beyond that lens, that perspective that says, I am this body, I am this confined entity, and seeing yourself not as any one thing, but as everything. That's the essence of the Mind Light book, to take you on that journey. So money's truth: I'm available to all who see themselves as me. How do we do that? How do we make that transition? Well, to see yourself as everything is the greatest act of self-love. Therefore, money is another name for self-love. Or said differently, money is a direct expression or extension of self-love. It wants you to see yourself as it. Seeing yourself as it, as everything, is self-love. Therefore, self-love is money. Money is an extension, an expression, an aspect of self-love. It's part of a continuum. So when you're honoring yourself, being self-loving, acting in a self-loving way, money is just one of the energies that reflect that in abundance. Now, I'm finding it challenging with the confines of this language to really express money and self-love is one. And I'm feeling you guys are getting a grasp around that. You see money and self-love as one, not even a product of the other. I mean, that is great. If you can see money as a product of self-love, that is a huge step. But go even deeper. See, it is the same thing. Holding a space of self-love is what creates money. But it's like an instantaneous thing. See if you can let that in. They're one and the same thing. And that seems to be integrating well. So to chase it is coming from money is worth more than I am. But to love yourself is coming from I am worth. I am it, for I am love. Love is what I am. In realizing this, you go from chasing money to it chasing you.
Thank you for watching, and make sure you give us the thumbs up if you loved it. Now, also remember to subscribe so we feel supported and we feel encouraged to keep making more videos like this. Now, my best recommendation is for you to check out the links below to find the perfect video for you. Choose whatever resonates. I'm sure you'll love it. Now, if you're ready to start boosting your intuition and tapping into that infinite intelligence of the universe, I suggest that you go to our free Boost Your Intuition workshop. It's the first step to creating the life of your dreams. The link is in the description below. We'll see you there.